Hello everyone, Gordablaze here, and I have something cool and special for you all today, my wonderful, awesome viewers. And if you've watched my old videos, you know that I'm a huge Harry Potter fan, and I was really lucky got to go to the Wizarding World of Harry Potter back when it first opened, like 2 weeks after it opened back in 2010. Well, now today I get to go and like 3 weeks after it opened, I got to go to Disneyland and California Adventures, and am going to show you. I get to go and show you around Cars Land. How awesome is that? I honestly don't know if you can hear me, but here, see, there it is, off in the distance. Behind the street lamps, Cars Land, and Disney California Adventures, and that awesome looking building they have there, off of the. I can't remember its name right now. Anyways, there, it's kind of nighttime, so all the neon lights should be on. It looks really cool when it's nighttime. And, well, if you didn't know, kind of what I was trying to lead up with the whole I like Harry Potter thing is, I really like Harry Potter, but Pixar is like the best thing ever, like really. The best movies ever. And hey, look, a Bugs Land. So there's like a Pixar themed area right next to a Pixar themed area in a California theme park. It's downright awesome. Hollywood Tower Hotel. Yeah. That's like one of the best rides in the park as well. Paradise Pier looking awesome off in the distance there. Really, it's cool. I mean, like, this whole park, its renovations have definitely really, really improved the park. Like, it is a true, cool, awesome theme park now. Really, if you didn't like California Adventures before, I advise you, come back now. It is, the renovations have definitely improved it. Here we go. Welcome to Cars Land. Route 66, Radiator Springs, gateway to Ornament Valley, population 12, elevation 160 feet. Knights of Combustion, Loyal Order of the Lugnuts, Association of Cogs in the Machine. And I can't read that last one, what is it? Downtown.
Okay.
Downtown Radiators something something. Anyways, here we go. We have Fillmore's house. Oh, and it's neon glory. Oil bins over here. There's the Pacific Wharf area over there. That's where the windmill's part of, I think. Basically, it's a taste in Fillmore's house is a little it's a shop pretty much. Little shop and store. Get to go and buy organic things like potato chips. Ooh. Over here on the other side of the road we have Towing and Salvage. And Mater's Junkyard Jamboree here. I'll try to get you to see this. I'm pretty much just going to walk my way down Route 66 here. There you go. Mater's Junkyard Jamboree. Yeah. Anyways, moving on now. That just looks cool. So cool during that, excuse me. Let's see, what's next? Soldier's Surplus Hut. And it lights up just like it did in the movie. Oh. Speed limit sign back there. Slow, 25 miles an hour. Okay. That's cool. Mailbox. And of course the American flag, but with the American flag on top for someone as patriotic as Sarge is. Carburetor County Tractor Feed and Farm Truck Association meeting first Tuesday of every month at 7:30 p.m. Sadly, you can't go into that building, but it's still pretty cool. Let's see, I'll go and cover the shops and the inside of the shops in their own video, separate from this one. So, yeah, look for that video. You'll see it soon. Anyways, we have coming up on our left now, the world famous Cozy Cone Motel. No vacancy. Oh, wow. 100% refrigerated air. What's going on down here? Hold on a minute. Cozy Cone Motel can wait. I think I see Flo. I have not seen Flo out before. It's threatening to start raining on me again. Please, hold off until the video's done. Oh wait, it's the cars from the start of the first movie. Yeah, I can't remember his name though.
Are you ready?
Remember from the start of the first cars, if you don't remember, here I remember for you. Him and three other cars were going along the road, just having a blast of a time, I guess, playing the loud music. Found Mac, the tractor trailer that Lightning McQueen rides in. They lured him to sleep because he was already falling asleep. And in the process, Lightning McQueen ended up falling out of the... He fell out of the truck and ended up in Radiator Springs here, and they actually kind of inadvertently caused Lightning McQueen's big turnaround and becoming a nice person. So yeah. Has a bit of a bad memory for me, so I'm not going to get into what the bad memory is, but it's kind of a bittersweet song for me. Anyways, there's Mater right there. We're going to loop around and see Mater from the front soon. Also, please, anyone watching this video, don't go and try to remove it for copyright. Please, don't be like the Back to the Future video I have for Universal Orlando. Well, we got blocked in Germany because of music playing in the background I had no control over. I really hate that. Anyways, here we go, the Cozy Cones. We have restaurants in them. We have Pop Cone. We then have Cone Coctions, bottled up by Cone Queso. Then Ice Cream Cones. And finally, Churros. One of these is not like the other. You know what? Cone Rolls. There we go. They are now Cone Rolls. Really though? I swear, like, the churros are sold everywhere here. It's insane. Like, everywhere I look in these two parks and outside the parks, there are churros for sale. It's insane. Like, what is it with South California and churros? Here, you got some water on the lens. There you go, Mater. Seen Lightning McQueen out and about, and Red as well, so don't know where they are though, but it's pretty cool. 10 minutes already. Okay. I'll try to wrap this up soon. We have the Doc Hudson Medical Clinic over here. Ornamental Valley Medical Clinic, my apologies. It's run by Doc Hudson, though, before his death in between Cause 1 and Cause 2, somewhere in those 4 years. Anyways, over here we have Flo's V8 Cafe, which is a nice restaurant, while you can go and eat inside the Ornamental Valley Medical Center. It's kind of cool. Also, they sell gas for sheep here. If only you could get your car inside, it'd be really nice. Now over to the left, we have the Model T Lizzie, Radiator Springs Curios.
You are the ultimate party car.
Like with the Sarge's Hut, I'll show that in another video, the inside of it. Because this video is already kind of running pretty long already. Hello again. Anyways, we have House of Body Art over here, which is it's another shop, I'll show it again. Down here we have a path toward Pacific Wharf. It's a nice food court area if you want to go there. And we also have the wonderful Willie's Butte. I hope I got that right. Anyways, turning around here, I'm gonna go back into the city. Over off that way is the path toward a Bugs Land. However, I will go down that way. Anyways, so I can show off Luigi's Passadella tiles and the flying tiles. I don't know if you know this or not, but the person who voiced Luigi in the movie, both Cars and the sequel and some of the video games, is the voice of Tony Shalhoub, the same person who played Monk. And really, honestly, that is awesome because I really like the TV show Monk. And yeah, I'm getting off topic here. No, I'm not, because it's all about, it's linked to Luigi, so there we go. Anyways, here we go, the flying tiles, which is kind of fun. It's basically a flying saucer ride. And, excuse me, you get to go and throw beach balls at each other. However, due to the fact that there's L being pushed up from underneath, if you try to throw a beach ball, it goes flying, literally. Like, it's like suspended in the air for a few minutes before the gravity, or not minutes, seconds, before the gravity comes down. Oh man, they're not running it right now. They're like, they just got off, don't. Anyway, so the beach balls, there are the flying tiles. It's very beautiful. Cool place. That way leads up to a Bugs Land in Hollywood Land. But that's not important right now because I'm showing off Radiator Springs. And honestly though, I like the movie Cars. Cars 2, it wasn't like the best, but it was okay. I mean, like, Cars is a good movie and I thought they did really good and I really liked the story. Cars 2 wasn't as good as the original, but it was like not the abomination that a lot of people say it was, so I like the Cars movies. Favorite Pixar film though, I'd have to say would be Toy Story 3, followed by Wall-E, and then The Incredibles Can Take Thor. Those are my favorite Pixar films. Anyways, over here we have a few more shops. We have the oil pan and Lube-O-Rama, the two bars of Radiator Springs. Long since closed though, I do believe. And over around the corner we have the actual Radiator Springs standing here, so races in the queue line to Radiator Springs Racehorse, which, like I said, is just around the corner. And then we have Sparky Spark Plugs and Corb Theodore. Two other stores that have since closed due to Route 66 no longer being the wonderful highway it once was, and the rise of the interstates pretty much. And now, the town hall / fire station / traffic court / sheriff, all in one building pretty much. The town of Radiator Springs. And of course, the town's founder, Stanley. Who apparently, though it's not really said in the movies, went and saw Radiator Caps. And there we go, Radiator Springs Racers, which has been ridiculously long in wait time. In fact, it doesn't look like they're even letting people in at the moment. Oh, jeez, darn, I was kind of hoping to get going right at the second time. Oh well, I'll have to see for myself. Anyways,
one more time, man.
Let's see, can you see my face? There we go. Yeah, sorta, kinda, no. There we go, yeah. Anyways, this is Gotta Blaze. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you next time, okay? Bye.